Hello, my name is Ashley Agnel Montero and I'm a second year medical student. Which is your name?
I'm Mrs. Savita Montero.
Okay. So today we are going to perform some tests to check the cerebellar function and the sensory function. We are going to perform a few tests. Are you ready?
Yes, sir.
First, we perform the finger-nose-finger test. The examiner holds his extended index finger at arm's length from the patient. Using his index finger, the patient is asked to touch the examiner's finger, then touch her nose. This should be performed slowly and repeatedly, with the examiner changing the position of his finger. Next, we move on to rapid alternating movement. The patient should make rapid alternating movements by patting her knees with the palm and the back of her hands by pronation and supination. Next, we move on to the heel to shin test. In this test, the patient slides the heel down the anterior tibial surface of the other leg. There should be a smooth movement and the heel should remain on the shin. Watch out for any deviations. For the next test, ask the patient to walk back and forth several times across the examining room. While the patient is walking, observe the posture and balance. Next, with the eyes open, the patient should be asked to walk naturally in a tandem fashion, that is, heel to toe. The examiner should remain near the patient to prevent injury in case the patient should begin to fall. Ask the patient to walk on her toes while the examiner watches carefully. Next, ask the patient to walk on her heels while the examiner observes her movement. Moving on, ask the patient to hop. For this, she has to use one leg at a time. Next, ask the patient to perform the shallow knee bend for a few seconds, one leg at a time. To perform Romberg's test, ask the patient to stand with feet together and arms to the sides. Stand at the side of the patient and extend your arm, one in front and one behind the patient. Ask the patient to close her eyes. The patient should be able to maintain posture without movement of the feet with her eyes closed. This is a negative Romberg test. If the patient cannot maintain posture and balance with eyes closed, ask her to open her eyes and observe. Next, we will test superficial tactile sensation. For this, take a small piece of cotton and note the patient's ability to feel the touch of a piece of cotton. For testing superficial pain, follow a similar procedure as previous, but this time use a toothpick with a sharp and blunt side. Be sure to show the patient the sharp and the blunt side before the test. To check sensitivity to vibration, place a vibrating tuning fork over the bony prominences like the shoulder, elbow, wrist, knee, ankle, etc. Note the ability to feel the vibrations. To check the position sense, the fingers and toes are moved passively and the patient is asked to indicate the position and should hold the finger or toe at their sides. Two-point discrimination. For this, simultaneously touch the various parts of the body with the two ends of an unfolded paperclip. Ask the patient if one or two points are touching her.
The distance by which the patient can differentiate one from two points varies for different areas of the body. To perform point localization, ask the patient to point to the spot where she was recently touched. To perform this test, ask the patient to identify the letters or numbers written on his or her palm or other body parts with a blunt object like a pencil or pen. To perform this test, you have to use your index fingers. Simultaneously touch both sides of identical areas in the body. Ask the patient to tell if she has been touched on one or both sides.